What's up, guys? It's J&A Exotics, and welcome back. So today we're going to be talking about how much it is to keep a green keeled bellied lizard. We're going to be comparing bioactive setups to a non-bioactive setup, and we're also going to talk about the benefits of a bioactive enclosure. So two things to keep in mind today before we start today's video. One, this is just going to be a rough estimate based off of prices in my area. And two, this is by no means necessary going to be a care guide for this animal. Now with that being said, we can begin. So for both setups, we'll be using an Exoterra 18x18x24 front opening tank. This is the smallest size you can comfortably keep the species in, and it already comes with a background. I personally believe it's easier to take care of reptiles with a front opening tank because it's less stressful on the animal. Most of the natural predators are birds, and there's always a possibility that when you reach in through the top of the tank, they think you're a predator trying to grab them. A tank this size usually goes for around $150 to $180. Now we'll talk about substrates. The basic setup we're going to talk about today is less involved than the bioactive setup, so we're going to start there. Like I did for my last video, I'm going to choose a personal favorite substrate of mine. I'm going to choose the Zilla Jungle Mix. A 24 quart bag is plenty for the tank size we chose. This size bag goes for around $25. The species requires a relatively high humidity level, and it'll help keep the humidity up if you have a layer of sphagnum moss. In my opinion, ZooMed sells the best cheapest bag of sphagnum moss around for $20. You can find cheaper sphagnum mosses, but they always have prickers and sticks inside of them, so it's not really worth it in my opinion. Like I said in my last pricing video, you're gonna have to change your substrate a few times a year, so I'm just gonna go with the number 3 just for the sake of the video. So if you change your substrate 3 times a year, that's $75 on substrate and $60 on moss. That's roughly $135 a year just on substrate. Green keel bellied lizards are an arboreal species and they spend most of their time in the lower tree lines and bushes looking for food. So to keep them comfortable and stress-free, we'll need to imitate their natural habitats. There's so many different possibilities that you can use for decor inside the tank. To start, let's pick some branches for them to climb on. I'm going to be choosing cork rounds because that's a personal favorite of mine, and these guys also like to hide in small spaces, and cork round provides a good surface area for them to climb on. In most pet shops, cork rounds are priced by weight. Medium to large cork rounds, a good size for this tank, will usually cost anywhere from $20 to $30. I have 2 cork rounds in my green keeled tank, so let's say we spent $60 on 2 larger cork rounds. Now there's a lot of ways you can decorate the inside of your enclosure. Depending on the brand, the prices of the decor may vary. To keep it simple, for today's video, I'm just going to choose Exoterra brand products. I'm going to choose 2 Exoterra silk leaf vines, an Exoterra fern, and an Exoterra bromeliad. Now the silk leaf vines typically cost around $15, and they'll do an excellent job imitating leaves, and they'll also collect water for the green keel to drink. The fern is around $15 as well, and it provides good ground coverage and will fill up some of the void space on the bottom of the tank. The bromeliad will do the same thing as the fern, and those typically cost around $20. Now green keel should also be offered a water bowl. It'll allow them to drink, and it'll help keep the humidity high inside the enclosure. Again, water bowls are pretty cheap, and you can find them for around $5 to $10. So in total, with all the decor, we're going to say we spent roughly around $135. Now things are going to be different and more expensive with a bioactive setup, but it's worth it. The tanks are overall just lower maintenance, and the cleanup crew inside will help dispose of the waste of the lizard. Now again, I know when people do bioactive enclosures, I know they like to make custom backgrounds, I personally do it myself, but for the sake of the video, we're just going to use the background that comes inside the tank. So we're going to start off with the substrate layers first. There are going to be several layers of substrate that you're going to use for your bioactive setup. You're going to have your drainage layer, your substrate divider, the actual substrate, whatever you're going to choose for it, and you're going to have moss and leaf litter on top of the substrates. For a drainage layer, we're going to be using clay hydro balls. Now I personally buy my hydro balls online because you can get a bigger bag for less money. For the size tank we're using, you can get away with buying a 25 quart bag of hydro balls. This is going to cost you roughly around $40. Now on top of the drainage layer, we're going to need a substrate divider. You can find those relatively cheap, both in stores and online. You can find an 18x18 substrate divider for around $7 to $10. Now you can go crazy and make your own substrates for your bioactive enclosures, but again, for the sake of the video, just to keep things simple, I'm going to be choosing one substrate that's already pre-made. I'm going to be choosing Josh's Frogs ABG Mix. Currently, Josh's Frogs is selling 4 quart bags of this for around $13. For the size tank that we're going to be using, you can get away with about 3 of these, and you're going to have to pay for shipping as well. So we're going to keep things on the higher side with taxes and stuff, and we're just going to say these bags cost around $15, so 3 bags of those is going to be $45, and we're just going to go throw an extra $10 on for shipping. So it'll be roughly $55 for the substrate. Now, I'm choosing to use the same exact sphagnum moss that I used in the non-bioactive setup, so that ZooMed sphagnum moss is going to cost, again, around $20. Now we're also going to be adding leaf litter for the bioactive setup. The leaf litter is going to break down over time and provide nutrients for your bioactive setup. It's going to also act as a natural hide for your reptile, and it'll also act as a hide and a home for your microfauna. I'm choosing to use magnolia leaf litter just because it's the largest sized leaf and it'll cover more surface area, and bags of that usually go for around $10. Now, in order for this tank to be bioactive, we're going to need some microfauna. Now, this unfortunately can be pretty expensive depending on what species of isopods you want to put in your tank and how many you want to start off with. Also, keep in mind that some larger species of isopods may end up being a snack for the green-keeled lizard. Now, personally, in my tank, I have dwarf white isopods. Now, these guys are small enough so the green-keeled won't eat them, and they do an excellent job of keeping the enclosure clean. Now, for a 10 count of dwarf white isopods, it costs around $15. With a larger tank like this, you want the isopods to be able to find each other, that way they can breed and make a population. Buying more than one 10 count of isopods is important because you want the isopods to be able to find each other and start breeding so they can establish a population. I think with this size tank, you'd be able to get away with 3 10 counts of dwarf white isopods. Now you're also going to want springtails inside the enclosure. Now just like the isopods, the springtails will help break down waste and they'll also eat different types of molds. You can buy a colony of springtails for around $12, and that'll be plenty to seed your enclosure. Now we're still going to need cork rounds, plants, and a water bowl for your enclosure. Now just like the basic setup tank, we're going to use the same price for cork rounds and the same price for the water bowl. So again, that was $60 on 2 larger cork rounds and $10 on a water bowl. Now how much you want to spend on plants is entirely up to you. A fair warning though, the species will trample smaller, fragile plants, so it may not be worth adding any. All my tank really has is a larger golden pothos because it's hardy and it can tolerate the green keeled climbing on it. Now this plant kit you can buy online for an 18-18-24 front opening tank, and they go for around $100, but in my opinion, I don't think it's really worth it for this species, but again, that's entirely up to you. So for the sake of this video, we're just going to say that we picked up a golden pothos, a dwarf umbrella plant, and some begonias from a local plant nursery. Smaller golden pothos plants will cost around $15 and will provide your tank with thick greenery and places for your lizard to climb and hide. Dwarf umbrella plants are a hardy background plant and you can find them for around $10. Now begonias will add some color to your tank so everything's not just green, and you can also find these for around $15. So with all these prices together, we're roughly looking at $302. Now keep in mind, this is also without building a custom background, and it's also without choosing expensive plants, so you can definitely spend a lot more money. This is also a lot more money than the basic setup, but again, bioactive is substantially easier to maintain. Now as I mentioned in my last video, the lighting aspect can really depend on your personal preference and what brand you like. So there's definitely plenty of different routes you can go for lighting. Again, for the sake of this video, we're just going to keep it simple. The species requires both UVA and UVB, so the easiest, cheapest solution is going to be to buy a combined UVA and UVB dome. Now I used this for my last video, so you guys already know that these domes go for around $35. So for a UVB bulb, I chose the Zoomed 5.0 Tropical UVB because that's what I use for my green keeled belly lizard. Now one of these bulbs costs $15, but you're going to need to change it twice a year, so that's $30 a year on bulbs. So for a heat bulb, it really depends on how warm or cold your house is. I'm assuming a 50 to 75 watt bulb will keep your tank and the hotspot at the right temperature. Those bulbs also cost roughly around $10 to $15. Now you're also going to need some LED lighting for your plants. The 12-inch LED light I use I found on Amazon for around $25. So with everything totaled up, it's going to be $105 just for lighting. Now green-keeled belly lizards can eat a wide variety of insects. They can eat things like crickets, dubia roaches, waxworms, mealworms, and so on. Now my green-keeled belly lizard is just about full grown, and he can eat 12 medium crickets in a sitting. Now it's going to be really tough to estimate how much it's going to cost for your green-keeled belly lizard to eat. There's many different factors, and I also don't know what you're going to be feeding it. Judging by the prices of feeders in my area and what I feed mine, it's going to cost you around $10 to $12 a week just to feed them. Now you're also going to need supplements for your insects. Now again, like anything else, it's really your preference on what you want to use. I just so happen to use the Zoomed Calcium and the Zoomed Reptivite. The Zoomed Calcium goes for around $12, and the Zoomed Reptivite goes for around $10. Now just like your UVB bulbs, it's good practice to change your supplements every 6 months if you haven't finished the bottle. So that's going to be $24 in calcium and $20 in vitamins a year. Now like I said in my last video, I feel like something that's really overlooked when you're looking at pricing out how to keep an animal is a mister to help keep the tank humidity up. The species requires a moderately high humidity level, so a good mister is important. Now a recommendation for me, if you don't want a misting system, go to Home Depot and buy one of their store brand pump sprays. These only cost around $15 and they do an excellent job when it comes to spraying down the tank. Now you're also going to have water for these guys for the pump sprayer and for the water changes. Now you can go to your local grocery store and find distilled water for a dollar. If you're just keeping the green keel lizard, I say with confidence that you can get away with buying just 2 gallons of water a week. That should be enough for your pump sprayer and for your daily water changes. Now again, just for the sake of the video, I'm assuming you don't have a stand to put the tank on. Instead of going out and spending all this money on a stand just for this tank, I recommend going out and buying a utility shelf. Not only can you stack multiple tanks on it, but you can also store all your supplies. You can buy a decent utility shelf for around $100. Now we have our tank set up, we have our stand, we have all the supplies that we need. Now it's time to buy the green keel bellied lizard. Now I'm going off on a limb and I'm expecting that you're buying a captive bred individual. True captive bred green keeled lizards are going to be healthier and they're going to be free of disease. Buying captive bred also puts less stress on the wild population. Now a captive green keeled bellied lizard can cost anywhere from $200 to $250. The species is well worth the money and I love working with them. Now let's see how much both setups are going to cost. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.